to our club for those of you who don't know him. And today he's speaking from the beginning manual, which we call Competent Communicator. This is a 1 through 10 project. Today he's doing project 5, which is Your Body Speaks, so expect to see some action up here. The objectives for you to evaluate him on his speech, papers in front of you, are these. He's to use stance, movement, gestures, facial expressions, and eye contact to express his message and achieve the purpose of this speech. And he's to make his body language smooth and natural. The time, Mr. Timer, is 5 to 7. Rob has worked for R&D Magco, an aviation parts supplier, for 19 plus years. He began his career as a cancellation machinist, was promoted then to production manager, and was recently promoted again to business development manager. He joined Toastmasters in January 2017, just this year, because he needed to give presentations in his new role and felt that Toastmasters would help him hone that skill. So let me introduce Rob Owens.
No pressure at all. Public speaking was one of my biggest fears. But I'm really proud to say that I can use that term was. Now, I still get nervous. That doesn't go away. But it's no longer that big fear anymore. 6 months ago, as Joy said, I had to change careers. They asked me to do something different at work. And I had to give presentations, and that's totally how I realized. Scared the hell out of me. Me, why me?
Why me?
And so I went online for some training to try to figure out, what am I gonna do? And I found Toastmasters. Now, there's a lot of different clubs when you look up Toastmasters, but I needed one that was gonna challenge me. And I found that here at the Peacock Club. Part of the beginning of my career, I was a CNC machinist. And to train for that, I had to go through and work for 8 weeks at a time with different people. The great thing about that was, every 8 weeks, I got to work with somebody new and take the great qualities about that person and add that to my skill set. And I see that same thing here, because not only do you get to give speeches and get feedback on those speeches, but you also get to listen to different people each week, see the best qualities about them, and then pull that into your own skill set. The first person that I had met here was Joyce. Now, Joyce seems to always be on. She always speaks precise and clear. She always dresses nice. And when she speaks, she has this authority about her, but yet a softness. There's also just a tinge of something there that tells me if you were to cross her, she'd curse you out like a sailor. Now, I've never heard her swear. Just this feeling I get. But I want that in my skill set. I want that authority, yet softness in my skill set. The cursing I've got a handle on. I don't need your help on that. The next person I met was Colin, the president of our club. Now, internally, myself, I still feel like I'm 16 inside. Probably has a lot of my insecurities because of that. But when I met Colin, he seems like this old soul. When he speaks, it's with such intention and purpose. But at the same time, his words are welcoming. I want that. I want that in my skill set, to have that intention, but yet be welcoming. Stephanie was the next person I met. And she offered to be my mentor, which has been a huge help. She's helped me with my speeches and given me advice. And in addition to that, shown me in the meetings how the meetings run and the different positions and what they do, and encouraged me to do different positions, almost being voluntold. But in addition to that, she's a great speaker. When she speaks, she has this knowledge she draws from, and her point always comes across. I want that. I want that in my skill set, to come from that point of knowledge and get my point across. Now, Letha's not here, but she's our sergeant at arms. She keeps the ball rolling. She keeps the club on track. She seems to me to be such a strong woman. And when she speaks, it has a smoothness, but at the same time, her words hit me like I'm back in the military with my drill instructor in front of my face. And I can't put my finger on how her words can be that smooth, yet hit me with that much power. But I want that. I want that in my skill set. Rick and his son Jim have been inspirations to me. They speak with such ease. Rick is just a natural storyteller, and Jim, he just seems so genuine when he talks. And it's probably because Jim is that genuine. It's who he is. I want that. I want that in my skill set. I want to be that, to be able to talk with that ease and that genuineness. Carlos. Carlos is smooth. Not slick, but smooth. Kind of like Carlos Suave. He dresses a little hipper. He talks a little more casual. But he brings you in when he speaks. He makes you think like you've known him forever. There's a comfort there. I want that. I want that smoothness. I want to be Rob Suave. And last but not least, there's Bill. Now, Bill, I heard, was an excellent speaker. And he does not disappoint. But it's not what you think. See, when Bill speaks, it's like a Pink Floyd song. It starts out with this melody that goes along, and all of a sudden goes in 10 different crazy directions, only to come back to this magnificent triumphant end. And you're like, how the hell did he get there? He speaks with such freedom, with his arms waving all over and his vocals going in and out, drawing you into that story. And I want that. I want that in my skill set. And I think that each week in coming to this group, I've been able to improve in my confidence, improve in my job, and I owe this group so much for their help. And what I found about this group is it is not a group of ordinary birds. No, it's a group of peacocks. Yeah. Thank you.